This Belgian singer-songwriter blends funk, soul, and reggae for a one-of-a-kind sound.
Cause it's love, real simple, and that's how it works.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Breton, and welcome to WatchMojo.com. And today we're speaking with Sela Su.
So won't you just give it up, cause you don't understand. Beg it up, but you don't understand.
How did you first come to follow music as your path?
Well, actually, you know, it was pretty late. It's not that my family was into music, you know. I really discovered it myself when I was about, 13, 14, and I got into puberty, you know. It was an extremely hard period for me, you know. It was I had a really hard time accepting who I was, and it was a hard road, you know. So for me, it was a bit my way to place things. My whole first album is about self-acceptance, for example.
You crazy world, crazy world, hey.
If you could pick one idol or icon that is your biggest influence, who would it be?
She doesn't have a lot of albums, but I think Lauryn Hill, she is really the best. I mean, in soul music, you know, her vocals, the sound of her voice, the way she rhymes, she can rap and she can sing. Her lyrics are so deep. It's not that I'm into that, you know, she's into God and stuff, and that's not my thing. But I really respect the way, you know, she made her first album.
This world ain't simple, but I'm strong. I know how to stay out.
What was the music scene like where you were growing up? Was there a lot of reggae available?
Not really, but I think, you know, we live in the age of, like, you know, you have a lot of internet. I mean, you have it everywhere, music. And I know Belgium, it doesn't sound really exotic, but you have a lot of cool artists there as well and cool musicians. And I lived in a place where, you know, when I was a little kid, you know, the big guys were like jamming every night on the guitar and singing Bob Marley and you know, it was a big bit of a hype in Belgium, you know, raga and reggae. And for the rest, Lauryn Hill, I discovered her through MTV, you know, through television, and Erykah Badu through some friends at school, you know, so that's a bit the way I found my music.
Yeah, yeah.
What made you choose to write in English?
Well, because, you know, I speak Flemish and it's really not exotic. You know, you have a lot of accents in the Flemish part of Belgium, you know, so it's like we are with 5 million people all over the world who speaks the language, which is nobody. And then even then you have like 20 accents, you know, so but mine is it's like it doesn't sound really beautiful. So that's why, you know, I chose to go for English, and I think it sounds most beautiful.
Listen to the sound of my voice. You better send him all my love, and he's given me no.
How did you learn English?
I learned it through friends and The Simpsons, and yeah, it's really true. I really grew up with those two TV shows, you know, and it's subtitled, so which is really good. When we were young, we heard the language a lot.
The ragamuffin is one of the end. What you see is what you really did in the end. But what you're gonna do, I don't know.
Does writing in a language that's not your mother tongue present any unique challenges to you?
That's a bit the challenge, because, you know, I have a lot to say, but I have, you know, of course, it's not my native language, so I'm a bit limited. I know that I always come to the same words, but I think it's really important to write good things, so I'm really open for help. Actually, I really want to write really good things with my message, but maybe we'll see later. Yeah, maybe I'll take some help with it, yeah.
I say, dear ragamuffin is one of the friends.